Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm, that is PyCharm version 2023.1 on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily write a simple Python program and how you can easily run that on our Python IDE. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, you can always put a comment in your comment sections. I'm always there to help you. And if you like the video, then please give it a like and also do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install the latest version of PyCharm, you need to first simply go to favorite browser. And in that this bar, you need to just simply search with PyCharm download. Hit enter. And you'll get this JetBrains.com as a first search result. So here you need to just simply click on this download PyCharm, and when you click on that, it's going to show you this JetBrains official site. So here you can see that our latest version is version 2023.1. So if you are watching these videos in some other time, you'll be able to see some different version, but it's going to be the process will be still same. You might see a different version, but the process of installing will be same pretty much. All right. So here you can see we have three options: Windows, macOS and Linux. So depending upon what operating system you are using, you need to proceed with those tab. So I am using it for Windows. I'm going to switch Windows and I'm going to click on this download button for the community one. Okay, so thank you for downloading PyCharm. You can see our download has rightly began. I'll be canceling this download because I have already downloaded it. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that PyCharm community 2023.1.exe is already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 403 MB. So now to install it, you need to just simply double click on the exe, and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and there you go. Welcome to PyCharm community edition setup. Installation wizard is rightly shown. So let's minimize our download directory, and here you can just simply click on next. So this is our destination folder. So they're going to create this program files, JetBrains, PyCharm community edition setup, this folder name. So this is totally fine. Only thing that you need to remember is this space required. So currently you can see it will going to take 1.6 gigabyte of space on your C drive after it finish installing. So currently the space available is 31.5 gigabyte, so that is fine enough, but you need to check this part, like whether you have sufficient space left on your C drive. And if you are okay with that, you are totally fine. Just simply click on next. Now under installation option, we have this create a desktop shortcut. So I'll be recommending you to check this PyCharm community edition, this desktop shortcut. So what it's going to do is it's going to create a desktop shortcut similar to IntelliJ IDEA. And similarly, you need to also check this open folder as project. So what that basically means is if you have any Python related folder project basically lying on your desktop, let's say, by just simply right clicking on that folder, it will going to show you this open folder as project. So you can directly open that folder on our PyCharm. And we are coding it in Python, so you need to check this .py, and this is the most important part. You need to check this add bin folder to path. So what that basically means is it will automatically going to set our this path in our environment variable, so you don't need to set that manually. Okay, only thing is you need to restart your system. I'm going to show you that point where you need to restart. So basically you need to check all these options and click on next. And it's going to create this JetBrains folder as I have told you earlier. Totally fine. Just simply click on install, and there you go. Our installation has rightly began. Also see, desktop shortcut is also being created. So this installing will take a couple of minutes. After that, I am going to again coming back to this video. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our PyCharm community edition setup is rightly installed, and it is asking whether you'd like to reboot your system now or you'd like to manually reboot later. So I'll be recommending you to reboot your system now and just simply click on finish button. And after that, once you are back rebooting your system, I'll be again going to show you what are the next steps. Yeah. So after successfully rebooting your system, you'll be again landed over to the desktop. So you'll be able to see that we have this PyCharm Community Edition desktop shortcut is also created. So let's double click on that shortcut to launch our PyCharm. And you can see our PyCharm is started launching. Before that, it will ask you whether you'd like to import previous settings. You can just simply click on OK. And you can see our PyCharm has rightly started launching. And you can see our PyCharm is rightly open. So welcome to PyCharm. It will also going to ask you whether you'd like to give the allow access to Windows Firewall Defender. Totally fine. So welcome to PyCharm. So let's maximize it. And now you can just simply click on this new project. So now I'm going to show you how you can easily create a new project in PyCharm. So here you need to provide the project name. So I'm going to name the project name as Hello Geeky Script, and all other things are fine. It's going to use this, you know, python.exe. So this is our Python project, so it's going to use Python. And all other things are totally fine. It went to create this main.py welcome script also. So this option is also checked. Totally fine. Just simply click on create. And when you click on create, it's going to start creating our project. See, it is currently creating our virtual environment. And you can see that our Hello Geeky Script project is rightly created over here. And it has also launched our main.py file. So this is, you know, whatever is written on that main.py. So what they basically doing is, this is our main, and here they are, you know, calling this printi method by passing this PyCharm as a parameter, and that they are calling it in this printi method. So here we are printing this hi, and then whatever we are passing here, that value get picked up here, and they're going to print this hi and this value, which is hi PyCharm. Okay, all right. So you can just simply click on this run button, and it's going to start, you know, building our project, and it's going to show you the output. And you can see that hi PyCharm is rightly shown over here, right? So if you change this PyCharm with, let's say, Geeky Script, and if you just simply click on this run button, it's going to do the same thing. The only thing is you need to change that PyCharm with hi Geeky Script message. Okay, so in this way you can easily install the latest version of PyCharm on a Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video. If you face any issues in middle, you can always put a comment in our comment sections. I'm always there to help you. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.